Let me ask you a question. When it comes to getting organized, do you feel overwhelmed and don't know where to start? Well, that is the number one question I get from my clients. And so today, on my new series, Your Questions Answered, I'm going to tackle that question. Now, if you have other questions that you want me to answer on this show, just drop them in the comments below and subscribe so you can make sure to see when I answer your question. So, how exactly do you get started when you feel overwhelmed? First things first is you want to start small. Most people tend to tackle the entire garage or take everything out of their closet and throw it on the bed and then start to try to make decisions about what they're going to keep and what they're going to let go of. My rule of thumb is 1 square foot by 1 square foot. You don't want to tackle the whole closet all at once. You can't take on the whole garage all at once. It just becomes way too overwhelming. So you want to start small. 1 little square foot, one drawer, one box, one little bag, because you know you have all those bags of stuff that you've let accumulate. It's just one small thing at a time. Decide on what you're going to work on first. And if it's the closet or the garage or the pantry, just start with 1 square foot of space, literally just a square foot. Work on that, create clear space, and then move on. So, how do you exactly address the clutter once you've chosen your square foot, your small space? So, the tendency is to take whatever it is that you're working on and dump it out in a big pile in front of you. That to me is an absolute no-no. That just automatically causes a state of overwhelm and frustration, and it makes it a lot harder for you to make decisions. So, what I like to do with my clients is I have them sort things into general categories. So, you start small, and then you're just going to sort into super general categories. It's pretty easy if you just keep doing it by room. So, whatever goes in the dining room, what goes in the kitchen, what belongs in the bathroom, what goes in the bedroom, what goes in the office. Just sort it into super general categories. And the reason being is you want to just get everything out or off of the surface that you're working on in an orderly fashion. And this is good because if you got interrupted, something happened with the kids, or you just were tired and you didn't want to go on anymore, you could contain every category that you've sorted and pick it up and put it away neatly and come back to it later when you're ready, instead of what usually happens where you have to take it all, shove it back in, and then it looks 10 times worse than when you started. So you just sort into simple general categories, okay? And by sorting into general categories, you're able to get a visual of what you actually have. So when it comes to deciding what you're going to keep and what you're going to let go of, it's much easier to decide when you see that you have 10 of one thing and 5 of another, that it's okay to let go of this one. So dealing with overwhelm and how to get started is simply by starting small, only doing 1 square foot at a time, and sorting into super general categories. Now you can go back and further sort those categories later into more specific categories, but the idea is to sort like a robot. It's just robotic what category something belongs to and just sort it out. The biggest rule of thumb here is you're not making any decisions. That comes later in the process. You don't want to combine two decision-making processes at once. Right now, you're deciding what category something belongs to. Then later, you'll decide whether you're going to keep it or let it go. You don't want to combine those decision-making processes because you'll just give yourself decision fatigue. So, no deciding. And everybody has the tendency to do this. The only exception is if something is literally a piece of trash, you don't have to sort trash. You can put it in the trash bin. But I don't want you making any decisions about what you've sorted out until you get to that step, okay? So start small, 1 square foot at a time, and sort into general categories. Then it's gonna make it much easier for you to decide later when you get to that step, okay? So to recap, managing overwhelm and getting started is simply start small and sort, okay? Now, if you have a question that you want me to answer on this series, drop a comment below and make sure you subscribe to my channel so you can see when I answer your question.